This is CBS Enterprises.
22 boxes. £250,000. Just one question. Welcome to Deal or No Deal? Welcome to Deal or No Deal. Yes, her name was Kate. Well, it probably still is Kate. And what a game we had yesterday. Every time a blue came out, Kate stood in the middle there and went... Ah! Oh, it was awful. I've just about got my hearing back. But anyway, there was a personal milestone for her. For the first time in her life, somebody gave her £22,000 tax-free. That's what she got out of the game. But there was a bigger milestone. Was a far greater significance to yesterday's game because he went past the milestone of having given away in this game £18 million. £18 million since we started, what, 27 years ago. Amazing. He's not going to be happy today. I wouldn't be surprised if whoever comes out here finds that every single offer involves buttons, tangerines, gravel, absolutely anything he can find other than money. Could be tough. Need a good player. Here come the names. Oh, my word, it's you. Ah! Marie. Yeah! 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 Marie, it really is your big moment. Please. Crazy chair away. Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to your game.
Thank you very much, sir.
Please take a seat. Marie Jones from Merthyr Tydfil in Wales, a dietitian's assistant.
That's correct. Mainly I work in the local hospital. Do a bit of work in the community as well. Both of weight management and people with malnutrition, especially the elderly in the hospital, you know, when...
Yeah, of course, it goes the other way, doesn't it? We think about obesity these days because it's so much in the news, but a lot of people do have issues about malnutrition.
That's right. Yeah, indeed, yeah.
Amazing. How long have you been doing that?
I've been doing that job now for about coming up to 2 years now, and it's fantastic.
Very rewarding, I
think. Very rewarding.
And you've got Alan here.
I have indeed.
Hello, Alan.
Gorgeous husband.
How long have you two been together?
10 years.
10 years? How did you meet?
A story behind that.
You've either forgotten or it's too embarrassing to mention.
Well, I work for the local authority and we're living in a council house. And I had to go there to do a job, take the chimney stack down. And three of us went to do the job. And I see Marie and thought she was okay. And ended up, my two friends took the chimney stack down and I was in the house chatting Marie up.
Isn't it funny? I heard it slightly different to that. That you had crows in your chimney.
That's correct, Noel.
And then you turned up to sort out this bird issue, but then found you had your own bird issue.
I did, yes.
And you found an excuse to go in the house and check in the bathroom to see if there were any men's toiletries. How about that? See whether there might be a way of moving in. That's the truth, isn't it?
That's the truth.
Yeah, you see? I know more about this than you do. Terrific. What have you brought along with you here?
Oh, I don't mind my grandfather.
Yeah, there we go.
Yes, that's my dear grandfather, Patrick O'Reilly. We had many happy years together. I got fantastic memories of him. And I was always with him, and if he was if he was alive today, he'd be sitting with Alan, as I can assure you. And he was a bit of a gambler, you know. He loved his horses.
We had a streak and, to him there.
Yes, and since he's gone, I got his presence around me. He's always with me, you know.
Sure he's here today.
He is with me today. And that's a little poem I wrote for dear Mr. Barker.
You brought your own phone?
Yes, I did. I'd like to read that before the show, if possible.
Yes, go on then.
Right. Dear Mr. Banker, before I start, I send you this message from my heart. As a child, I was taught to all concerned, respect was important and must be earned. I've respected many people in my time. It's your turn now, Mr. Banker. You've now got mine. But to grovel to you would be a sin. So with greatest respect, may the best woman win. Good bless you.
I like that.
Nice little phrase.
And that's my grandpa's prayer book. And when he passed away, I've taken hold of it and I treasure it. It's one of my most dearest possessions, to be honest with you. And I'm hoping it's going to bring me luck today.
Excellent. Are you happy to go on?
I am indeed.
Your big moment begins right now. I need the confirmation, please, that you chose box 21 at random before the game began.
Yes, I did.
It is sealed by the independent adjudicator who seals all 22 boxes and is the only person who knows where the money is. Marie, Alan, I hope you have an absolutely wonderful game, and I hope, particularly because of your sentiments in the poem, that the best woman wins.
Yes, also.
Marie, good luck!
Now I haven't got a system.
Excellent.
So first, I'm going to go to Gorgeous Lucy, number 3.
Good luck, Marie.
Yeah! Aurora, please. Lovely Aurora.
How are you today?
I'm fine.
How's Sid? Did you see him afterwards?
Yes.
Will you be seeing him again?
I will. I mean, he's got a lot of money, of course. I'm after the money.
A little romance with Sid's game. Lovely.
Good luck, my darling. Okay?
Thank you.
You look beautiful.
Thank you.
I'm going to miss our little chats.
I know, miss you.
All blue so far.
Lovely Carol, my Betty, who came the first day with me, so please make it a blow.
My best.
For a very long time.
The gorgeous Ginge, number 12, please. Okay.
Good luck, Marie.
Thank you. That's okay.
That's all right, though. That's okay. No, that's fine. That maybe got a groan from a couple of people. That's fine. If that had been the first box of the round, no one would have groaned. But it was just because we had an expectation there that it was going to be an all-blue opening round. But that's pretty good going. Hello. How are you? Are you feeling hard hit in the pocket? Over 18 million quid you shelled out. Oh, that's at least a holiday for him, he says. Are you not feeling confident today? Ah, Rosemary, yes. You had an incredible average, didn't you?
I did indeed, yes.
amazing big boxes, one after another. Yeah, quarter of a million, 5 times. You got a poem for me? Go on then. Thanks for your poem. And respect you, I do.
Thank you.
I'm hoping for once that you'll have a small blue.
Oh, very good.
I may have to play dirty if all else fails, because I often have trouble with women from Wales. Yes. Are we looking at number 3? Thank you very much. Huge average, he says. Your box, in that short time that it took you to select 5 in the opening round, has now risen to a value of £12,000. 12 grand for box 21.
Very nice offer, a very respectable man. But, I've come here to play the game, Noel.
Good.
So I'm ready for the question, please.
£12,000, deal or no deal?
No deal.
Spend it! He's here to play the game, don't you worry.
Terry, please, number 15.
Terry, welcome to the game.
Thank
please
you
open box 15.
All the best, Marie.
Serenity is delivering.
Cal, number 4, please. And before Cal, can you do the pigeon?
Quiet, yeah, please, yeah. Everybody. He does an impression of a pigeon.
You can do it now for me.
Good. All right.
Good luck. Hope it's a blow.
15,000.
Okay.
Not worried about that. Stack of chicks.
Number 1, Nicholas.
Hold it right there, Marie. I hope you've prepared for this moment. Quite clearly, you put a lot of effort and thought into this game because you came with your poem. And no doubt you've got a message for the nation to encourage them to return for the 3rd box in this round.
Please come back. This me you're gonna thank when you watch me give this banker a jolly good old spank.
Told you. Marie Jones. Not them going. Welcome back to Marie's game. It's all very serene. And it's working very well. This serenity is working very well. There is only one place where it is not calm, and that's the banker's room at the moment. He is really hoping that this is going to be a major hit on your game. You all right, Nick?
I'm good today, thanks, Noel.
Yeah, you're looking very good. Could we have a blue out of that box, please?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah!
£12,000 opening offer.
Good job, mate.
More of his money crossing the bridge into Wales. Oh, don't say shut your face. Oh, he's angry. Calm down. It's not over yet. There's a glimmer of hope. You don't like hearing. You've annoyed him by cheering and supporting her so much. The banker is livid. Look. She's come along here with the right attitude. She's going to take you for a huge amount of money because she's here to play the game and the boxes are being kind to her. Yeah. Thank you very much. 15,000.
Lovely. Thank you very much.
Climbing. Steadily climbing.
Very, very, very respectable offer. But obviously, I'm ready for question.
£15,000. Deal or no deal?
Thank you very much. No deal.
Thank you. is going to be very interesting. I think this is your really important round.
Yeah.
If this round is 5,000 downwards, he has a massive problem. In other words, keep that block of six intact, and the banker is going to have to be reaching for a very fat wallet.
Rowley, please. Number 20.
Thank you, Rowley.
Marie, I hope it's a blue for you.
Never mind.
First relief for the bank.
100,000 still there. Yeah. It's still there. But don't worry about it, Rowley. I chose that box, right? Don't worry. My neighbour, Roy. Number two, please, Roy.
OK, let's regard that as a blip. And you know the finest way for her to come bouncing back is the 1p.
Absolutely. And who more could I expect a bigger kiss from than Marie?
Ah, right.
With my neighbour from the beginning. It's not who doesn't rain in your prey today.
Dan says that's okay.
She's had
either end of that block.
Laura, please, number five.
All right, Laura. It's all gone very tense. The atmosphere has changed quite. Yeah, the atmosphere has changed dramatically here. In fact, the 250,000 or the 20,000, either end of her block, got to leave that intact. 5,000 downwards, please, Laura.
Yeah, good luck, Murray.
Yes, that's okay. I think, unfortunately, the 5,000 is not enough to balance the $250,000.
So no.
He's going to have his first go at you. Hello. Go on, why is she nervous? Me? You know about her when she was a little girl? Ah, yes, wanting to phone swap shop.
Oh, if you didn't have a phone.
Oh, didn't have a phone. What did you do, then, without a phone?
We scoped it. There used to be a red telephone box up by the... there was only one phone in the street when I was a little girl. And I was only six, and my mother wouldn't leave me go up on my own.
Oh, hang on. He's alleging there's more to that story, Marie. What did you do to the phone receiver after you'd used it?
Well, we was a gang of kids, as you are when you're children, you know what it's like. We used to sit on the bench, and it was right outside the phone box. And we used to get a stick and put it in dog. Put it on the receiver of the phone. And when anyone...
How did you know that? Oh, you haven't. Oh.
That's a true story, Harris.
He would be tempted to cut you in half with a $250,000 going.
Naturally.
But he's not going to do that. Because with that sense of humour, you are his kind of girl. And I think he's offering you 9,000 and me some disinfectant.
Right. Well, considering what I just took out, that was a very respectable offer, I've got to be honest though.
Yeah, Alan, what do you think?
Well, it's a great offer. But I think there's enough blues to take out before that set of four. So it's up to you.
I'd like to know.
It's up to you,
me. He thinks there's certainly one more in it. The good thing about that block is, of course, you can't take them all out in the next round if you decide
indeed.
To go on.
Yeah, that's true.
Marie. Yeah, said that. Marie.
Oh, hello, here she is. The psychic psychologist. How are you feeling today?
Yeah, good.
Are you
getting any
buzzies out of anything?
Well, I was just going to say, I don't have a particular feeling about my box or Marie's, but I did do what you asked me to do.
Did you?
Yeah.
What was that?
I said pray for me.
Pray?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's very spiritual,
eh? Yeah, a little prayer for Marie, and it's, you know, it's in your hands and his hands. And
yes.
You were really serene at the start, and, you know, maybe you just lost the focus a little bit.
I think.
Just think carefully about the offer, but...
To get back into my zone. Fancy. Very respectable offer. But like I said, I am new to play the game, Noel, so can you ask me the question?
£9,000, deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you.
Thank you. Debs, I'm going to come to you.
OK.
So do your best now, please.
You're a lovely lady, Marie.
And you are.
Worth a low groan.
Okay.
We got to get back to this opening run.
I know.
Amazing game, really. You had that wonderful opening run, and now it's completely opposite.
Yeah. Number 10, please, Lillian.
Lilo, we're pretty desperate now to find the 1p and the 10p.
I'll certainly try, Marie. You've been a lovely mother to the group. Good
luck.
Thank you, Lynn. Oh! Wow. This is one of the most astonishing turnarounds I can recall.
Yeah.
A fabulous opening, just a couple of reds that didn't really mean a lot. Lovely blues, and now a relentless run of reds and all the wrong reds.
Mm. Come on now, everyone. Positive. Come on. Lucky for some, 13, Hassan, please.
All right, Hassan, the game has turned around. Oh, no. We had such a wonderful, optimistic opening. We'll be opening that box right after the break, and I think you'll be back to see whether this lady can now flip it back the other way and regain control of the game. See you shortly. Welcome back to Marie's game. It's all really dependent upon this turning out all right, so our spirits are raised, Hassan. Raise our spirits, please.
Marie, you're a lovely lady. I'm wearing blue, and I hope this is blue.
Thank you, Hassan.
Very good.
Thank you.
Yes! Yeah! Well, I think it would be misplaced optimism to say that the game has now gone back in your favour. It's 4-4, but the reality is he's got his most influential two and you haven't.
Indeed, yeah.
And so it's not balanced.
No.
Hello! 35,000. 100,000 swung his way.
Indeed.
And then he makes this horrible noise. He just goes, ka-ching. It swung in his favour. You're feeling better now, are you? What's the big problem she's got? Yeah, the 1p and the 10p
yes,
still
yes,
there.
Yeah.
If you'd managed to take out one of those, the 1p or the 10p, or please both, then the offer would have been somewhere in that gap on the right-hand side. As it is £3,000.
Right.
Now, this is quite a little journey you're on here, starting at a fabulous 12, climbing to 15. That's how good that early bit was.
Yeah.
Back to 9 and now down to 3. Mm. 3,000. Al, what do you reckon?
Do you reckon that?
It's a good offer, considering the board.
Oh, yes, yeah.
Totally up to you, Marie.
Hello.
6
to go up there. You can get rid of them small 6. Take your prayer book in your hand, walk round with that, Marie, refocus and start looking at that board with your prayer book in your hand.
I will do that, Gary.
I think you should.
Thank you very much. I will do that. Right, Noel. Thank you very much. I'm ready for the question, please.
£3,000. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Yeah. might turn out to be quite brave.
Number 18, Gary, please. The
right.
Daddy.
You made the suggestion of the old prayer book, which he's clasping and really hoping now to do the damage top left. We know the offer will start to climb if we take those two out. Gary, it'd be great if you get a kiss out of this one.
I'm hoping for a kiss, Marie. I really am.
Great if you do the other one now.
As lovely Sid called it, the dead man's box.
Dead man's box, yes.
Number 22, please.
Okay. Don't want it to have any morbid, deadly qualities whatsoever, this box. 1p would be brilliant, David.
Good luck. Forget a blue here. Brilliant.
Well, it lived up to its name. It took out the top of the game. And now
that's
we have
right.
a one
still
box
got the 50.
Game.
Still got the 50. Keep poker.
Choose this one wisely. We've got a one box game. We've got to miss it.
Number 8, please, Dan.
Oh, Dan, I so much want to see that 1p go. Come on, Dan. Anything but the 50,000.
There's no doubt Merthyr has been a poorer place without you. Good luck.
£3,000. Oh, you want to keep that?
From Boston.
Oh, I think your resolve is going to be tested by this offer.
One box game, no, no.
It's a one box game, and unfortunately that 1p is acting like an anchor.
It is indeed.
It's just dragging everything. Trying to remember the last time we inducted two members of the 1P Club in 1 week. I can't recall when we did it. Oh, he says this is most unfortunate for you because you've been so helpful to him.
Aww.
Destroying other people's games,
he's
left, right and
yes,
centre.
He's right.
Yes, he thinks this is very cruel for someone who's been so supportive. The odds now. The odds are on his side. One box game. Chances of you taking it are over 60%. He wants you to take this offer. What's it going to be? How much do you value box 21 now? 1,500. He's halved you. £1,500 is the value of the box. Yeah, feel free to groan if you want.
Well, considering the board, that is still respectable. No, I mean...
That was a bruising round, that was.
Terrible round. I am going to think of this one all at the moment. I don't know. I really don't know what to do on this one, to be honest though.
Do you want Alan down here?
It's up to Al. How do you feel? Do you want to come down?
Come on down, Al.
I think personally, Lee, you might have the 50,000 in the box.
Yeah, true. I'm just hoping, going on my track record. Had some nice little numbers in there.
You've had the most enormous
run. I just wonder, would the banker be so kind, or someone be so kind to tell me if I've had the 50 grand before? Well, I know it's a lot to ask. How many times have I had the penny, if possible? And I think I've had it once.
OK, I'll go back through your record and possibly we will get an answer. Hello. She would like to know if she's had the 50,000 before and how many times she's had the penny. You've had the penny once before.
That's correct, yeah, I right to remember that.
And you've had the 50,000 once before.
Oh, interesting.
He says the only thing you should focus on is the fact that your game smells worse than a Welsh telephone receiver.
Marie, just be prepared. I mean, we talk about a gambler's board. That is a gambler's board. You've got to think about how you're going to feel if
worst case scenario, best case scenario, and how you're going to feel if, you know, would you feel worse if you had 50 in your box and you didn't carry on, or if you do carry on and you have a penny in your box?
Indeed.
Are you ready for the question?
I am indeed.
£1,500, deal or no deal?
No deal. Number 11, please, Owen.
It's kind of pretty obvious what we want to see and what we don't want to see. Owen, will you please remove the seal of box 11? Owen, lift it.
Good luck.
Yes!
Number 19, please, Paul.
I tell you, I really, really want you to get to the next offer, which is going to suddenly soar. It'll be one of the biggest uplifts we've had. Paul, break the seal first.
OK. You really deserve us to be a Blue Marie.
Paul. Lift it. It's all right.
It's all right. That's fine.
Clearly, you got to find that 1p, and then you're flying. You really are. £100, £50,000 finish. We'll put you in a delightful position, because the next offer is going to be so much more attractive than any place you've been since the very beginning. But it's left or right. It's 16 or 17 for your destiny.
17, Elaine.
Elaine? Same form. Break the seal first. We're committed. Open it, please.
Good luck, Marie.
Sorry. Come on, I've had a fabulous time with you guys. Come on.
Your commitment, your style of playing the game, your bravery deserved a lot more than £100 or a penny. Hello. If she had turned the other way, what a different result. Gone the other way, you'd have been offering 11,000.
I know.
As it is, it's £11. Wow. What a journey there.
I know. But if I'm going to go out with anything, I'd like to be in the Hall of Fame, so open my box and find a penny, please, no?
£11, deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you. This is your destiny. I can't recall the last time that we had two members of the 1P Club in 1 week. It doesn't get that cruel, does it? Here we go. Are you the 24th member of the 1P Club?
Didn't you? Bessie, you've got it over there.
Amazing. How are the two of you feeling?
Oh, no, Angelina, well, I'm gutted. I am gutted, but I'm not a greedy person either, and I've had a fantastic time and... Just thank you ever so much.
All right. Marie, it's been a real pleasure to have met you, and you, Al. And it's £100.
Thank you.
Oh, and there is a tangible sense of disappointment here. I've not detected this atmosphere for a while. We feel sadness for a player who has a really bad game. And sometimes we feel a bit of anger because of the way that the banker performs. But I think everyone's disappointed. There was a feeling that Marie was going to join that exclusive club of people from Wales who take it for a lot of money. Not to be. We'll be around over the weekend to be part of your weekend. I look forward to that moment. See you very soon.